So, we're supposed to tell a funny story about Mark? That's kind of difficult. He told the funny stories. I remember one story told about his brother driving, and there was a cat, and there were guts, and windshield wiper fluid, and... Anyway, you wouldn't think that would have been funny, but he made it funny. Dave, hope you can retell that story tonight. Would love to hear it in your own words. And just want to say one of the fondest memories I have of Mark is when I first met him, he knew I had a dog. He asked what my dog's name was, and I told him Paul. And he said, after Paul O'Neill? I was shocked. Nobody has ever gotten that before. But Mark, in addition to being a great guy, was a Yankee fan, so that kind of put him over the top for me. Miss you.
Mark had an infectious smile, and he would grin, and his eyes would get big, and he'd be intense, and would say, yeah, yeah, yeah. But then he would, all of a sudden, get serious and think, okay, yeah, and then go right back to smiling. And that was infectious, and that was really, really good. And we always enjoyed seeing Mark, especially when he was there at the Londoner. And I know whenever we went to, say, for example, a birthday party at Dave's, Crossan would ask, gee, I hope Mark's going to be there. And I really enjoyed seeing him smile. I liked that infectious smile.
When I first met Mark, I didn't understand his selectiveness. He knew exactly who he wanted to hang out with and exactly where he wanted to go to hang out. But I eventually grew to appreciate, understand, and respect his selectiveness, and it leads me to my favorite moment with him, when we went to dinner together before I left home for Christmas break last year, and halfway through dinner he decided that my food looked better than his, so to appease him I switched him plates, and of course he was right, my food was better than his. But looking back now, I laugh at that moment, and I'm so glad that I had that time with him. And even though his selectiveness might have driven me crazy at first, and I might have not understood it completely, I always felt like I was in a hand-picked secret society of his, and I'm so glad for all the time that we all shared together, and I will definitely miss him.
Hi, my name is Joyce Olson, and I'm a longtime friend of the Howard family. I had the privilege of having Mark in my honors biology class, and he was in my seventh period class along with his good friend Mark Bixby. And we had lots of great memories from our year-long study together of biology, but one that I especially remember is when we were dissecting fetal pigs. And at the time, Gross Anatomy was a movie that was being shown, and the students thought it was just wonderful that they got to do a lab practical with their fetal pigs, just like the students in the movie Gross Anatomy got to do a lab practical with human cadavers. My recollection may be failing me, but I think Mark and Mark were both really proud that they both got 100s on their lab practical. I remember Mark as a kind, gentle young man with a great sense of humor. And my prayer for the Howard family is that the wonderful memories they have will sustain them through this difficult time in their life.
Hello, my name is Favio Moreno, and I met Mark 7 years ago at Razor. We had worked for 2 years and really never had a conversation outside of work, although he was great. It was great the time we spent at work until one day when we went to happy hour, we randomly started talking about music. And the one thing everybody should know about Mark, he had an awesome appreciation for music and just great taste for finding new music. Well, after a few Boddingtons and a long conversation, we became great friends. Mark, you were an incredible human being. I will miss our 6-hour lunches, although Paula will miss it too. She used to found a way to get me out of her hair. Hope to see you again another lifetime, my friend. Take care of yourself. and I love you. We'll see you again.
Hi, my name's Aubrey, and I met Mark 2 years ago through a mutual friend, Brenda McClain. I was in town visiting her, and we went out one night, and I met Mark, and just moments after meeting him, I realized he was such a great person, and so fun to be around. That night, funny story, he found out one of their mutual friends saw a picture of Brenda and I and made a comment that I was going to be his future wife. So that whole night he was texting and sending pictures, teasing this friend that he got to hang out with me. And then that next day, just a bunch happened at lunch, and just something funny real quick. I decided to go into this canoe that was over an open flame. Thought it'd be fun to take a picture, and Mark helped me in, and then halfway through, he realized it probably wasn't the safest thing to do, and then he decides to come in there with me. Not exactly sure why we thought this was a good idea at the time. Did I mention we had some wine? I'm thinking that's probably it. So always good time with Mark. I'm going to remember the nice and funny memories that I have. I feel so blessed to have met him and to know him, and I'm sure everyone feels the same way. My prayers and thoughts are with his family and friends. Thanks.
Hey, yo, what's good, everybody? This is your boy, TK, and I met Mark about 7 years ago at Razor. Mark, I just want to tell you, man, I really do miss you. I can't believe you're not going to be part of the Wolfpack anymore. You, me, Favio, Carlos, Brenda, Jeff Judge, Julia. I mean, we're all down here hurting that you're gone, man, and I want you to understand that you meant a lot in our lives, man. You touched us, so whether it was laughter, a listening ear, or, hey, maybe the times, you know, we had to listen to you, so I just want you to know, man, hey, we really miss you, man. I appreciate wherever you are, you're rocking your Adidas, you're drinking your Boddingtons, and life's probably a little bit better, so, hey, we'll miss you, man, and I got a little Tupac playing for you in the background, you know, because to the end of time, man, us and your family, man, we'll forever miss you, so, hey, peace, man. See you, brother. Love you.
Back several years ago, and he had a beautiful wedding. He was really, really happy. There was a special cruise around the New York Harbor, kind of at sunset and in the evening, and I just remember how excited he was, how happy he was, and it was a really lovely evening, very intimate affair with just a few people, and I remember thinking that's kind of how the Howard family always was they had really deep friendships with a group of people that they just really cared about, and I always thought I was really lucky to be a part of that. Mark was always really kind to me, always generous, and I remember that evening after the cruise to be a part of that. Mark was always really kind to me, always generous, and I remember that evening after the cruise ended, I think they had limo escorts or something just really nice and high-end, and we went to Times Square, and he and Megan actually took pictures right in Times Square of their wedding, she in the wedding dress, he in the tuxedo. And they looked so happy, and all these passersby kept saying, oh, you know, congratulations, we're so excited for you. And I just remember thinking it was a really cool place to do wedding photos. I don't think I've ever seen anybody else do something as interesting and creative as that. And I think the pictures turned out great. I also spent a Christmas with the family. I remember a lot of stories that Dave had about growing up. I think there was some kind of occasion where the Houston house almost flooded and they had to move everything outside onto the yard or into the second floor. There was something complicated about flooding in the house, but from all of Dave's stories, it just sounded like Mark and Dave had such a wonderful childhood and really played together, were the best of friends, and had the benefit of such a loving mom and dad. And I remember when I first met Mark, just the last thing to say, He mentioned he worked for Pizza Hut, and I thought that was so neat. I was like, wow, free pizza all the time. And he said something like, yeah, you get over it. So anyway, I just wanted to share those memories of Mark and say what a great family he came from and how kind and loving the Howards always were to everybody in their lives. And I just, you know, I just wish everybody the best in finding whatever's next and whatever piece will come over the next couple of months and years.
Good. Come on.
Hi, my name is Brenda McClain. I have known Mark for about 7 years. About 7 years ago, I started a company called Razor that Mark worked for many years, and he walked into my office. He's like, hey, BMAC, I need something. I turned and I looked at him really funny, and I was like, one, who are you? And two, what is this BMAC thing? No one's called me that since high school. Well, he started a trend, and it took off from there, so everybody now knew me as BMAC. What I didn't know is 7 years ago that one of my best friends in my adult life had walked into my office. You know, a little bit about Mark. One of my great stories of Mark is when we left Cabo, I bought a cheap bracelet on the beach and those sand mites that get into them in Cabo. It made my arm swell up and it was really disgusting. Kind of looked like a virus on my arm. And we were in the airport in Cabo and he turns and he looks at me and goes, they may not let you through customs. They may think you're bringing a disease back. And then he goes, his typical look. Which made me laugh, but I was probably the only person in Cabo San Lucas with a sweat coat on over my jacket to make sure that they'd let me through customs and I had covered up my arm because it was so disgusting. You know, one thing we'll always remember about Mark is his look, his hug that's just a big arm and a slap on the back and he's done with you. To Mark's family, you know, you raised an amazing man. He had everybody's back personally and professionally. One thing that you knew about Mark is if you were close to him, he's always there for you. You know, Mark, you were my friend, my confidant, you're my life coach, you're my personal counselor, and your Boddingtons at the Londoner was much cheaper than $100 an hour, well, on some given nights. But anyway, I miss you, I love you, and you take care, buddy. Bye.
Hi, my name is Mindi. I hung out with Mark and David all through high school and college. I'm privileged to have been a quasi-member of the Howard family for many years, a lifetime ago. Mark, I've missed you for 15 years. That's not going to stop. I think of you with a coyness that was always tempered with an unmistakable humility. That's how I think of you. To your amazing family, I am grateful. Unspeakably thankful for the impact that you all had on my formative years. I love you all. I always will. Mark, goodbye.
My name is Peter Swulius. Mark was my friend and my best friend's brother. The first time we met, I thought he was the funniest man alive. It was like he had my sense of humor, but was just way better at it. But a lot of people felt that way. He talked about his family the way I talk about mine, the way Dave talks about his family. I went on a Howard family vacation many years ago. We shared a lodge and watched movies and ate lasagna. It was really great. Mark, thanks for brightening my day every time we were together. I miss you, man.
All right. Trying to shoot a Mark tribute video. This is, probably one of the hardest things I think I've done. Definitely wouldn't consider myself shy, necessarily, but I don't know how to kind of encapsulate what, you know, what it all meant or what it all was about. And you definitely told me that life's really short. At any point in time, you could really lose somebody like that. That's something pretty hard to deal with and get a grasp on, but, you know, I didn't understand. I mean, you're a good friend of mine. So, as long as you knew that, I mean, you knew that. One of the things I can say you taught me was that right before you left to go to St. Louis, you were one of the only male friends of mine that ever said, I love you. And, you know, that kind of taught me that, you know, hey, that's okay. It's never something I'd ever done before. And I was like, you know, without even missing a beat, I was like, hey, man, I love you back. You know that. And that's just probably one of the realest things I've ever dealt with. That was pretty cool. So I appreciate that for you. From you, should I say. Now, as far as stories, we have plenty. Too many to really point out one between you and I. I mean, sorry, parents and grandparents, a lot of them involve drinking. So, but that's really, we spent a lot of time at work. I think I met you in 2003, 2004 at Euro. And pretty much we're like fast friends from that point on, from playing golf or attempting to play golf back then at the little three-hole golf course over off Waterview. Moving on to becoming you moving over to Razor, and then you kind of being my mentor and kind of helping me deal and learn the franchise side of the business. And then all of the countless hours we spent traveling back and forth to L.A. and Harrisburg and all the airport time and the bar that we pretty much owned in Carlsbad, California, where there was just you and I sitting there wondering, where is everybody? The funniest story, and I think people want me to tell this one, but this is probably better left for the Londoner, is about our interview in Atlantic City. You know what I'm talking about. Pretty funny story, and yes, this will go down to the time you finally beat me. Everybody's understand what that means later, I suppose. But hey, miss you. To the family, I'd say I feel you guys' pain. Never really lost a friend that close, but and it'll never be what you guys feel, and I definitely understand that. But I want to say thank you for the opportunity to say something, say something about a good friend of mine, and kind of spend this time with you guys, maybe meet you guys for a moment. Really appreciate it. And I guess I'll exit with the Mark face he would do anytime you stomped him in a question. So I was, and give you that kind of look there. Oh, and then I know my boy wanted to be the first non-athletic Adidas sponsor. So really wish we could make that happen somehow. I'm going to have to go buy some Adidas gear or get a hold of one of those jackets, man. We'll celebrate Mark Day from here on out and wear Adidas on these trips to these places we never got to make it to, man. All right. Love you. Take care. Bye.
Hi, my name is Mark Smith, and with my wife, Sandra, we raised our kids together with the Howards on Spoonwood Drive back in the early 1980s. My memories of Mark was that he was a very quiet kid, but after you got to know him, he would open up and tell you everything he knew. We had a lot of fun with him, and Graham and he were the best friends for a number of years, did everything together, every holiday, every summer. They were inseparable.
I'm Meredith. I was little, I was younger, but we found some pictures I'll show you real quick. This is Graham and David and Mark on Halloween. We did several Halloweens together with them, and then here's a couple others of them, just best friends. So my memories of Mark are that just my brother's first best friend, and I tried to tag along, and I remember Mark being sweet, just a nice kid, and at times nicer to me than my own brother, who didn't necessarily want his little sister tagging along, but just a really kind-hearted little boy is what I remember, and just happy memories of being neighbors with the Howards.
Now, I'm Laura Smith. I'm the baby of this family, and as they mentioned, our brother Graham and Mark were super close as childhood friends, and we just want to send all our love to all of the Howard family from the Smiths here. Just want you to know that you're in our hearts, and we just cherish the memories we have with you, and just love you very much and wish you all the best.
My name is Graham Smith, and my parents, Mark and Sandra, and my sisters, Meredith and Laura, moved into our house next door to the Howards in 78 or 79. And Mark was my first friend ever, and your first friend when you're 5 or 6 years old is your best friend. And that's who Mark was to me. One memory I have of Mark is kind of crude, but when we were that age, 5 or 6 years old, it was pretty funny. We used to eat lunch together every day before we'd go to kindergarten, either at his house or my house. And it would usually consist of peanut butter and jelly, chips, and some type of drink. My recollection is we usually had apple juice. Before we would drink our apple juice, we would have to recite the following chant: power to burp, power to burp. And then we would chug our apple juice and wait for somebody to belch. And Mark was the best at it. He usually had the loudest burps, and we usually end up us laughing at his burps and not mine, because I wasn't very good at it. But we did that all the time when we ate lunch together, probably much to our mother's delight, listening to six-year-olds burp at the table. But every time I drink apple juice or see it at the grocery store, I think of Mark. And it's something I'll never forget. So to the Howards, thank you for being such great neighbors all those years ago. And Mark, thank you for being my first friend.
Hi, my name is John, childhood friend of Mark's. Growing up, the Howard brothers and the Bixby brothers shared a lot of playtime. One of our hot spots was the Walden swimming pool. We spent countless hours in those waters. Played our own versions of baseball. We perfected various dives off the board. We even dreamed up fantasy scenarios that allowed us to triumphantly and heroically come out on top. I don't remember once leaving that pool without pruned fingers, sore spots on parts of our feet, or satisfied smiles plastered on our faces. I will always remember Mark Howard in that light, joyful, innocent, and full of life.
My name is Mark Bixby, and I was childhood best friends with Mark H. Known him pretty much my whole life. Our parents were close, and Mark and I became close at an early age and stayed close basically until we went to college. Both went to UT, and I was in the liberal arts, and he was in the business school, and it's at that point we kind of started to go in our own different directions. But up until that time, we were the closest of friends, and maybe even more importantly, the closest of allies. When I think back about Mark H. and my relationship, I kind of think about us as sort of partners in crime in a certain sense. Whatever bullshit artistry I mastered in my life, I certainly mastered it because Mark and I were sort of each other's wingmen. I think that you could say that whenever we were in situations where Mark and I sort of needed to get each other's back, I think you could say that we both had a creative perception in certain cases of how things might be perceived by other people. But the awesome thing about Mark and I with our creative perception is that if Mark was perceiving something creatively, I would always get his back and tell everyone else how reasonable his perception was, and vice versa. He would do the same thing for me. So I think we often both emboldened each other to perceive the world in a very similar fashion, and I'll never forget that. Mark's sense of humor, his dryness, his ability to make everybody laugh with a facial expression or just a few simple words, I'll never forget. And while the two of us, maybe at our worst, would sometimes border on being a little bit condescending to the people around us and our own little galaxy that we shared together, we were always dead right. Mark, rest in peace, my man.
Hi, my name is Julia Proctor, and I've known Mark for just more than 8 years. I actually met him when I was moving to Dallas. He was one of the first people I ever met because he actually interviewed me for the job. So when I got to Dallas, there were two things, and I got into my interview, there were two things that I was thinking. The first was, I really hope that he likes me, and I really want this job, I really need this job. And the second was, I wonder if all Texas guys have that definitive part in their hair, like Mark did. Well, I came to learn that that was a Mark thing, that was a great, and then I also learned that Mark thought I was great because I obviously got the job and moved to Dallas. But you know, right after that, Mark went over to Razor, and I didn't really talk to him as much. And then I went to Razor, but we still weren't friends. But my favorite memory of Mark is when I knew that that's when we were going to be friends. And that was when we actually got to go on a trip to Sacramento, great city in California, for a work trip. The first thing that happened that just shows how great and kind and nice and poor Mark, the travel girl had booked the tickets, and she booked Mark's ticket first for the flight. Well, then when she went to go book mine, she found out that she had booked Mark the last coach seat, and I was going to have to go and sit in first class. So she was devastated, and Mark, you know, was just like, whatever, it's okay. Everybody was telling me to give up my seat and have Mark sit there because he was, you know, he was a director and I was only a manager. But he told me to keep it, and, I mean, he gave me a little slack for it, but all in all, it was good. But when we got to Sacramento, we went to this hole-in-the-wall casino in a little shopping area. I mean, it was really, really, really trashy. We thought we were in a really bad neighborhood, but it was the only place that was open on a Sunday night when we got into town. But there, that's where we actually became friends. Like, we just started talking about everything that was going on with us and had some really great conversations. And it was then that I knew that we could be really good friends. Also, we took out the water bottles from the casino. They had their own water bottles with their own labels called the Phoenix Casino. And that little label is still in my cube, stuck to the wall right now. So, Mark, I miss you. You were by far one of the most influential people in Dallas that I've known. And I could not have asked for such a better friend. And although I would like to say that I was one of your favorite girls, I do know that there is another girl that has your heart. And so she would like to say something. Miss Autumn, come here. Come here. Hold on. So, Miss Autumn misses you too, and she loves you. She misses your kisses and your walks, and she misses being chased by automatic cars. That's what she told me to say. So, we love you, and we miss you.
Hey, my name is Miles Croney, and I am the cousin to Mark Howard, and probably one of the most things I remember from him was 4th of July when we would all always play volleyball in the pool. And I'd always want to be on his team because I always looked up to him and he always took interest in us. I mean, being little kids as that. So he'd always like to spend time with us, even as annoying little kids. But I mean, I always enjoyed his company.
Yeah. Hey, I'm Mason. I'm Mark's cousin. I just remember, he's been there pretty much through my whole life. He was there when I was born, obviously, I don't really remember it, but he was there. He's been there for me pretty much my whole life, and he was just a really big part. He was always there, like, over holidays. I would always go to my aunt's, Diane's, be there during Christmas, Thanksgiving, see him all the time. He was always super funny, really, really fun guy to talk to, really funny, always had something funny to say. Huge into sports. He loved his baseball. Just really, really cool guy. I'm totally gonna miss him. Really sorry that he's not with us any longer, but he's definitely in a better place, and see him soon. Thanks.
Hello, my name's Rosemary Croney, and I am Mark's aunt. And I've known Mark since the day he was born. I was 15 years old, so since I was a young aunt, I have a lot of great memories, probably more memories of him hanging out with me. I got to take him places, got to embarrass him. I used to make him uncomfortable. I used to take him and ask him to go put our name on the waiting list, and it would make him very uncomfortable. But I've got such a strong relationship with him when he was smaller. Him and his brother David both. As he got older, as usual, you know, people kind of go their separate events and holidays. We had a special name for Mark at times. We called him Maurice. And Maurice is someone that we would ask, go get us some more salsa, go get us some more chips, Mark. Go fill up our drinks. And we just laughed, and he always had such a good attitude. So we had his name of Maurice, but he had his name for his dad, Wapper. And I used to think that was the cutest thing. Mark also is a creature of habit. He loves tradition. He had his favorite foods. And for those that know Mark, Mark was pretty particular about certain food items. He did not like his food to touch. He didn't like certain textures. Always made his favorite foods, and he did love that. He didn't want anything to change. He wanted everything to be just the same. He loved holidays. Loved being able to come over and spend the night at my sister's, and couldn't wait to do their traditions, their stockings and the Christmas tree. And he was just such a wonderful, wonderful guy. And we're going to miss him so much. He brought us so much joy. One of the things I do want to say is I never wanted to play games. We used to play board games, Trivia Pursuit, and hated playing against him because he was smart. And he always was quick-witted, too. He would come back, and my sister and I always laughed because it would take us days to think of something to come back. And he was very, very funny and just good humor to be around. So our holidays are not going to be the same without him. But we do have great memories of him and all his little funny sayings and all his little quirkiness, which made Mark. That's what made Mark Howard. And I love him so much, and I'm going to miss him. And I'm just glad that I was his aunt and that I could share a big part of his life with him. I've got a lot of special memories of him and love him very dearly.
Hi, my name is Lindsey Carneal, and I am Dave Howard, who's Mark's brother's girlfriend, and have been for many years now, and I've had the privilege of being an honorary part of the Howard family, and I've gotten to go on many ski trips and enjoy Christmases and holidays and birthdays and a whole lot of special occasions over the last 7 years, and I've gotten to know Mark really well as a result, and you know, always enjoyed seeing him, and that was definitely something that Dave and I relished, especially on a vacation. And I've had a really hard time condensing all of those years into a video clip, to be honest. I feel like my memories have turned into a soup that's hard to distinguish each piece, but when I think of Mark, I think of an incredibly well put together, funny, extremely intelligent, witty guy that loved Adidas, among many things. He had several pair, and loved greyhounds. He adopted a greyhound, and that dog lived better than most teenagers do in Highland Park, so the dog had a pretty good life, and its own room with a sofa and TV and everything else. So anyway, he had a big heart, and as far as memories go, so many, but a couple of ski trips ago, I had brought Eddie Murphy Delirious to watch one night after basically all the, what seems like the adults had gone to bed, even though all the three of us, Dave and myself and Mark, are in our 30s. And I'd kind of forgotten quite how raunchy it was and how many expletives there were. And as we were watching it, I remember we were all kind of feeling like little kids, afraid we were going to wake his parents up or that they'd hear all the F-bombs being dropped. And so anyway, it was our slumber party moment, the slumber party of our 30s. So, and I don't know, I just think about going to concerts a lot and having a beer. You know, Boddington's was his favorite at the Londoner, and I just think of so many things. So anyway, Marco, we'll miss you.
Hi, I'm Dave Howard, Mark's older brother. Older by 18 months, so technically I got here first, but just barely. And can't even really remember what life was like before Mark. Yeah, he was my best friend and my constant companion for my entire life. And I just don't even quite know how to proceed without him. But, you know, we have to. Anyways, I just wanted to say thank you so much to everybody who sent a video in and everybody who came today. It's been really great to relive some of your memories and be reminded of what an awesome guy Mark was. And we all love him so much, and we're going to miss him forever. And I can't believe that we have to say this, but goodbye, Mark.